going deeper into the correct way to execute your bong style, okay? And when we talk about bong style, in previous videos, we'll just do a little review of some very basic right, wrong aspect of doing bong style, all right? So when you do bong style first in the form, all right, your bong style is going forward and circling forward to the target. Your bong style elbow should not be popping up and out to the side with that, all right? And that's very important as we go forward, because to learn to execute the power of any and all of your motions into the target and the person to have to deal with that, so they are always having their center of gravity attacked by your motion. So let's just review that motion first and foremost. When I'm here and I palm strike, he juts out. Now when he comes in and punches, I go with it and I apply the bong style. Notice when I'm here, palm strike and he punches, I don't just pop my elbow up that way. Because now let's go deeper into it. Anytime I do any motion in Wing Chun, I am executing the power potential of my motion at that moment in time. I never want to, what we say, give solid ground to the opponent. Now, watch what happens when I do it incorrectly and I give him a solid ground, okay? So I palm strike, when you punch, put a little more power into it. So palm strike, when he comes in and punches, yeah, and I'm here, notice my body kind of gets pushed back from that, all right? Because all I did, when he comes in and punches, I'm bringing my elbow up, and now I'm creating that wall, and now he can push against that wall, okay? Remember, one of the big things that we're learning in Wing Chun, and I was reminded of today, is we are always learning to go with the flow, okay? And to go with the flow, to go even deeper into that concept, I go with the flow to execute my power into the person, whether it's through the attack motion or even a potential blocking motion. I have to go with it, apply the power, and then let it relax, just like how you would throw the ball and just how you take every step of your life. I wind up, I execute the power, I relax, so the process can continually repeat. So when I'm here and I do the palm strike, and we'll take it slow, when he comes in the punch, I'm going with it here. I'm dropping the elbow, going with it. Now I can go forward and apply my power of my structure at that moment in time to meet that. And that's how I transfer the power of my body ultimately to him, by attacking that, okay? Through that process. I don't just come in and I do like some hard structure and just let him come in and attack that. Because if I do that, two things are gonna happen if it's a slow demonstration style. One, I'll bounce off him or he'll bounce off me. But if I do that in real time, think about getting pushed, right? If Phil comes in and pushes me, yeah, we can just, I'm gonna step back from that, even if it's a light push or heavy push. Even me doing it against the mountain in Game of Thrones, if I just came up to him and pushed him, yeah, I could push him back, you know, a step or two. Because that's, you know, a dynamic versus static object. But to deal with the force is what you want to learn to do, so that ultimately you can apply your power to the target. All right, so that's what we're doing here. So when I come in and I palm strike, from here, I'm learning to go with the force. He comes in and punches, I'm going with it. Now that I went with it, I can apply my power to the point of contact, and now I have to let it relax at the end of the motion. That relaxation at the end of the motion is extremely important too, so that you can flow to the next motion. Think about when you walk, right? I take an even step, and that power doesn't fluctuate from step to step to step. Again, assuming that the ground is level. Obviously, if it undulates, that might be a little different. But if you're on level ground, that step, that walking is gonna be smooth and even. I don't put 5 pounds into my left leg and then 10 pounds of force into my right leg. You won't walk naturally that way. But the process is what you have to learn to do so that you can ultimately apply it at higher levels. So when I'm here, even from here in the tanzo, I'm winding up, and now he winds up and he learns to go with it with jutsu. When he comes in and punches, I wind up and I apply the power of my bong style. And then I let it relax at the end of the motion. Now, he comes in circles underneath, he winds up, and I go with it. Now, when I come in the punch, he winds up and he goes forward into the bong cell. And I go forward and I have to apply my power into the punch. And if I apply the power correctly with the body behind it, he'll feel the power transfer and attack his center of gravity. But if I don't know how to release that power of the motion, I won't be able to attack his center of gravity. And you learn to do that through every drill that you do. But do you understand that process and that concept? Because ultimately, it is a universal process and concept in actually everything you do in any martial art that you would do. Because if you're not doing that, you are fighting that force. Good luck.